Hi, I'm Dr. Zach Watkins, founder of the Live Well Clinic and functional medicine doctor. And people sometimes ask, is, you know, the inability to lose weight tied to my ability to sleep? And I think in this society, in this day and age, when we're running and we're going and we're fast and we're getting less and less sleep because we think we're more productive, the problem is that literature clearly shows, literature meaning medical literature, that actually the less sleep we get, the body kind of goes into this fight or flight mode, meaning this is a bad thing. It's a stress to the body when you're not getting the sleep that you need to recover and to rejuvenate. You see, your body makes a hormone called cortisol, and the more of this hormone that you make due to things like infections or poor diets or blood sugar and things like that, but namely in this point, lack of sleep is actually going to make your body store more weight. It's actually thinking that you're under some kind of physiological stress and strain because you're not recouping, repairing, rejuvenating. And when that sets in, your immune system takes a very, very strong hit. And because of that, your body's in this defense mode where you're gonna store more weight, you're not gonna detox as effectively through the liver, so you're gonna store more fluid. So there's a lot of negative impacts when it comes to lack of sleep and difficulty losing weight. Now, like personally, what I do, and I actually would recommend people to do, is get a sleep mask. You know, those goofy kind of things you wear over your face. I never did it because I'm so vain that I was even worried about what I looked like when I was sleeping in the dark. But what clearly has been shown is that even small specks of light, even a little bit of light that comes in through your bedroom and hits your skin is activating your brain to kind of keep that sleep-wake cycle going. So be pitch black room, blackout curtains, shut the door, no night lights. Obviously your phone beside your bed is not a great thing, and doing the Twitterverse and all that at night. Leave that off, and then but get a sleep mask to really shut this stuff out completely. Maybe you're in a stage of life where you have small kids and babies and your spouse needs to maybe get up a lot or needs to have a small light on. Great. Put a mask on to block that out, to really protect you. And it's not just laying in bed. It's, is your body rejuvenating? Is your brain shutting off? And are you shutting off all stimulation from your eyes that get to your brain that keep you awake? So that's one big thing I do. Another thing that I recommend people do that I personally do as well is they make different kind of sleepy teas that you can get at night. Mine contains things like GABA, theanine, magnesium, and a little bit of a sweetened flavor from stevia. So I'll make it like in a hot tea, and it's part of my way to wind down at night, but also it kind of sets in that motion of a kind of resting and falling asleep. So that is my tips and my recommendation for you. Don't underestimate sleep. 7 hours minimum a night, hopefully 8, maybe even 9. I'm speaking to myself because this is a struggle for me as well sometimes, but the literature, medical literature, is saying that good repair, rejuvenation is gonna happen at that 7 to 8 hour mark. And not just laying in bed for 7 or 8 hours, but actually physically sleeping. So it's gonna be hard at first, because you're not used to it and you're gonna lay there forever. Really try to get your brain in motion. Really try to create that circadian rhythm where your body's gonna know to fall asleep when it's dark, but also rise when the sun comes up. So when it comes to weight loss, metabolism, don't underestimate the value of sleep. Get your sleep 7-8 hours a night, because this is gonna set in motion the other physiological processes that need to happen when it comes to weight loss.